I'm Kara Winger, Team USA javelin thrower. I've been in the Olympics in Beijing 2008, London 2012, and Rio 2016. You can have a really powerful throw, but if the angle of your javelin isn't correct, you'll miss out on a lot of distance. So today we're going to talk about the technique of holding the javelin and upper body positioning. I'll demonstrate for you and show you some drills to practice it. One of the first basic things to learn is how you're going to hold the javelin. There are three ways to do it. You can put your middle finger at the end of the grip and wrap the javelin into your palm. This is the European grip. You can put your first finger at the end of the grip. That's the American grip. You can put your index and middle finger on either side of the grip. Little used, but some people swear by it, the fork grip. I use the European grip. I just feel better connection to the implement. I can be a little bit more flexible in my shoulder with this grip. Try some different things, figure out what works best for you, and practice that. So some key things are to keep that tip by your eye, keep the javelin parallel to the ground, maybe slightly angled up, but a common mistake that people make is letting the tip go straight to the sky. The way that you get loft in the javelin throw is by angling your body into the throw more so than the javelin. The javelin throw is a stretch reflex. It's really about generating forces all the way through your body and letting that stretch reflex propel the javelin as far as possible. So the key to doing that is keeping your throwing hand back as long as possible. Once you come into the throw and you hit that block leg, you want to be really disciplined and let the stretch reflex build through your body rather than crunching into the throw and decreasing your distance. The first drill I want to tell you about to learn how to control the javelin is just a simple withdraw. So you're not moving, you're just going to have the javelin in a carry position. When you're running down the runway, this is where the javelin would be. And then you'll just pull it back into a crossover position. So this is where you would be moving sideways down the runway and back. And you build really specific good control strength in your joints when you do this drill. So your hips stay straight forward and your shoulders are the things that are turning back to pull the javelin to your eye. For more tip control and arm control as you move down the runway, I made up this kind of silly drill to keep your arms still while your body is moving around by just jumping around while you have the javelin withdrawn. So you're just gonna jump. And instead of letting your arm flop as you jump, you keep it controlled. And just practice being disciplined in the position of your right arm as the rest of your body does something else. So remember, find the grip that's right for you. Keep the tip of the javelin by your eye. The javelin stays parallel to the ground. The angle of its flight comes from your body. And focus on small details to make your withdraw instinctive on the runway. It's important to pay attention to the details because then when you get to competition, you can just focus on doing your best. These seem like silly things, but they can go a long way towards making you feel comfortable in high-pressure situations. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to the Olympic channel for more tips. Let me pause for a second.